Hey, what's going on everybody? Welcome back to another video, and we have another fun DaVinci Resolve for iPad update. And no, this isn't an actual update with the DaVinci Resolve app itself, although I think everyone was extremely relieved when we saw that there was an update and they didn't remove the whole like shortcuts tab thing so you can get all of the pages. No, instead this news is about the best preset maker out there, MotionVFX, has been able to port over all of their DaVinci Resolve presets for the computer and now available on iPad. And right before showing how it works, how to install them, and how to access them in DaVinci Resolve, I just want to say a quick thank you to the now over 380 people who have joined the little community I started around an iPad course. Talking about DaVinci Resolve for the iPad as well as the computer, but I had no idea how many people would enjoy the more structured environment, more sequential steps if they're just getting started or transferring over from Final Cut or Premiere. And because I can see clearly now that it's something you all are enjoying, I've been working hard on building it out to be an even bigger resource. I'm adding a lot more videos, I'm adding more raw footage, more resources, project files, and I'm very close to releasing that updated version. Of course, anyone who bought into the course before when it was in its very basic structure, I'm going to transfer all of you to the new platform that'll exist on my website, so no worries about having to repurchase or anything. And anyone who purchases at the discounted rate now will still get in once the new platform launches. You'll just get the simple version now, but in the next, hopefully, week, the more built out platform will launch, and I'll send an email out to all of you. So if you want to take advantage of that, make sure you check out the top link in the description below. So anyway, MotionVFX created an app for iPad, and it's incredible. If you have no idea who MotionVFX is, they basically build plugins for DaVinci Resolve, Final Cuts, Adobe After Effects, and Premiere. But what makes them so amazing is not only are their plugins very professionally designed and unique looking, but also they're just so easy to install and maintain thanks to the M installer, which is something that you would install on your computer. And then once you bought the various plugins, it gets attached to your account. You open the M installer on your computer and just simply click install and you're good to go. Well, they've taken that same simplistic workflow and brought it exactly over to the iPad. So once you go in and you've purchased whatever DaVinci Resolve plugins, you now download their new M installer app for iPad, and you will instantly see all of the available plugins on the iPad. And I was trying to see if it was just some DaVinci Resolve plugins or if it was all of them. And I don't see anything on their website that shows like, oh, this DaVinci Resolve one is just for the computer or just for the iPad. So to me, it looks like all of the DaVinci Resolve plugins are available here, but you are only going to see the plugins that you have purchased in here. So this is not all of the plugins available. These are just all the plugins tied to my account. When you first open it up, you're simply just gonna see all your plugins and you just tap download. For the first one, you're going to need to assign it to the proper folder in the Files app, and it shows you exactly where it is. But just in case those instructions aren't simple enough for you, you essentially go to your Files app, hit on my iPad, open up DaVinci Resolve, and you'll just click open. And where they will actually put it is in the Fusion templates. It looks like where all of them install. Of course, if you're installing LUTs, then those are going to go into the LUT folder. I can see MotionVFX, and there they are. Some of the presets have this little info button next to it, and when you click on that, it'll essentially telling you 3D elements are not supported currently on preset 15. So if within that pack, if there is a certain element or maybe 3D tracking tool that is utilized in that preset, they weren't able to port it currently to the iPad version. And so it's basically going to tell you that like, hey, this specific preset is not here. Or like in iJustine's preset pack, it looks like presets with multiple drop zones are not currently supported due to an iPad limitation. So anything that doesn't have that little info, you can assume that that entire preset or preset pack is going to work as expected. Now, once we jump actually into DaVinci Resolve, you can see I have one of the presets opened up here, and we can find them by simply going to the effects. And of course, if I search titles right here, I can go down just like on the computer, and now I see all my various options here. So I can go in and, you know, grab that YouTube subscribe button that I always use, because you guys should be subscribed, and we can see a playback here. If you notice that it's a little jittery, I definitely recommend turning on your cache. If you're having trouble getting really smooth playback on the iPad, it's actually a video that I'm finishing up for my course, so you'll be able to check it out again, link in the description if you're interested in that, because there are different ways to get better playback on the iPad than on the computer, at least in the ways that the interface looks. But once the cache is rendered out here, we can see it plays back beautifully. If I open up the inspector, I'm gonna get all the same lovely controls that I have on the desktop version. So before this was available, what would happen if I had a project on my computer that I had a bunch of motion VFX plugins utilized on? They were just blank, like blacked out title cards on the iPad version, and now they should work just fine. The app is super simplistic. You can't buy any of the presets in here. If you're just using your iPad, just go to Safari and then go to motionvfx.com and you'll buy the presets there. They only show up in M Installer once you've purchased them and attached them to your account. If you guys have any questions, let me know down in the comments below. See you guys in the next video.